Our coffee breaks with researchers aim to spread knowledge about regional development and innovation. By sending a camera around the world, we present you with different angles and insights on the topic. We ask researchers directly and in a personal manner about their work. We want to make scientific knowledge accessible to all. Hi, welcome to Coffee Break with Researchers. Today, I'm having a coffee break with Bjørn Asheim, professor at the Business School and Center for Innovation Research at University of Stavanger in Norway. He's an expert in economic geography, innovation studies, and regional innovation systems. Hello, Bjørn. Thank you for accepting my invitation to a coffee break. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
I'm having a Colombian black coffee. Which one are you having?
I always have a macaron in the morning.
Today, I would like to talk to you about this recent paper, which discusses the importance of combining unrelated knowledge for economic diversification and a new path for industrial development. Could you please tell me what the paper was about?
The paper focused on unrelated knowledge combination and new path development, written together with Marcus Grillitsch and Michaela Trippl. And it tries to sort of present a strong argument for the need to try to achieve transformative activities, which sort of is represented by more radical forms of new path development, and that requires a long-term innovation policy to be supported.
And how is this possible?
Now, it's possible, first of all, you have to have a long-term thinking, let's say 10 years programs. And we have seen example of that in the Swedish innovation policy, which has been very successful. OECD calls Sweden the most resilient economy in Europe, precisely because it's long-term program. And you need long-term program to do something that goes beyond differentiation, that only do some modest changes, what evolutionary economic geography can call related variety. You do something different, but not very far from what the region has been doing so far. And this is a short-term thinking or medium-term thinking that are important, but you also have to address the more long-term challenges or more radical changes.
And how can you achieve more radical changes?
So one type of example we use here in the article is looking at what can be achieved by applying key enabling technologies. So we have one concrete example where we demonstrate how you can make silk of Hermes quality by the waste of making orange juice. So that is transformed into textile by the help of analytical textile, analytical knowledge base. Then you need the traditional knowledge-based synthetic or the textile industry to make the cloth. And then because it has these sort of aesthetic qualities, so it also incorporates symbolic knowledge-based that make it usable in the fashion industry. And there you see one example of how unrelated knowledge in the form of knowledge bases are combined.
And how will regions need to redefine their innovation policies based on these findings?
And the most important thing is to have this long-term thinking. And I think it's necessary then to have some sort of a national regional collaboration. Because in most countries, the big funding is either national and sometimes supranational in the EU. But then you have to design in a way so it's not only top-down, but also bottom-up, so the region can decide on how they should prioritize the user support, which kind of industry they should try to sort of support. And that's the design of the Swedish sort of centers of expertise programs, that they have this top-down, bottom-up type of our design, which also fits very well with smart specialization thinking.
And could you please tell me what was your main motivation in doing this research?
The motivation was to try to sort of go beyond this sort of short and medium-term thinking when it comes to how new types of new path development. which has been dominating the academic literature, but also policy making, due to this strength of evolutionary economic geography that points out of this sort of potential related variety and regional branching. You branch out of what you have, but not very far away.
Thank you very much again for this nice conversation, and I hope to see you next time in our coffee break. So have a nice day. Bye-bye.
I hope so too. Perhaps in a nice cafe in Vienna.
Thank you for watching. If you are interested in more details about this research, you can find here the link to the academic publication. And I hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.